Hey, it's SGU, and welcome back to the Billy Bravo Career Series here in Madden 17. Bravo and the Broncos are on a three-game winning streak. They're now 7-5, and today they'll be taking on the 8-4 Tennessee Titans. Yes, the Titans doing quite well for themselves, Marcus Mariota and company, and this will be a tough challenge for the Broncos as it is a road game and facing one of the league's best offenses. Here you see the AFC playoff picture now. If things ended today, we would have a wild card spot, but things are not ending today, and there is quite a logjam here in the playoff picture. So the Broncos owe it to themselves to try to pull out a victory here today and make their playoff picture look a little brighter. If they can get to 8-5, that would be great. Marcus Mariota going over the game plan here with coaches as they try to find a way to carve up this pretty good Denver defense. Now, Billy Bravo, on the other hand, is going to go against a defense that I believe is pretty highly ranked against the run. Against the pass, I'm not so sure. They're going to set up a screen right here. C.J. Anderson is going to get a first down on 2nd and 9. Nice play right there. Is had a chance to bring him down from behind, but the tackle was not successful. Now Anderson on the run is going to go to the right-hand side and pick up a first down. So he's done this both out of the backfield and taking the handoffs. 1st and 10 at the Titans 45, and you've got play action, and you're throwing deep. And that is Emmanuel Sanders, who's back from injury. Welcome back. Billy Bravo is more than happy to have you in the lineup as it provides another threat deep down the field, and Emmanuel Sanders beats his man right here. Is that McCourty he went against? I'm not sure, but he is able to haul that in, and the big strike puts the Broncos in business at the 13-yard line, 1st and 10. Ronnie Hillman checks into the game, and he'll get a 2-yard gain. 2nd and 8 turns now into 3rd and 8 from the 11. And that throw is to the end zone, and it is caught for a touchdown. Great opening drive by Bravo and the Broncos. They are able to punch it in here as you see the pass to Jordan Norwood. And that is a Broncos score on their first possession, putting the pressure here on the Tennessee Titans to come answer back. Well, they've had a great offense this year. Let's see how it goes in this game. Did they just fumble the opening kickoff? Either that or they fumbled on their first play from scrimmage. It's a turnover, and the Broncos get the ball at the 21-yard line. What a gift here, as they're already up 7, but the blitz, look out. The blitz gets Billy Bravo, takes him down. Stafford is the one to do the honors there. It's going to be 3rd and 18 now. Can they come back and get this? Well, he's going to check down to Anderson, who makes a man miss and almost picks up a first down. He's going to be 3 yards short. Nice gain by the running back, however. And we'll just go ahead and kick the Brandon McManus field goal to make it 10-0. Now the Titans coming down the field. They have a 4th down, and they'll kick their own field goal to make it 10-3. Later stages of the first quarter, under a minute to play, 2nd and 10. Pass out to Jordan Norwood, who makes a man miss at the sideline. I thought for a second maybe he was gone there. They get over to help and shove him out of bounds at midfield, but that puts Bravo over 3,000 yards passing on the season. 2nd and 10 now from the 50. Handoff? No, it's play action. The blitz is coming, but this time he gets it away. Again to Norwood, connecting with him quite often to start this game. 3rd and 3 as Bravo takes a hit, but he's getting up from it. That, of course, is the most important thing right there. Keep your quarterback healthy and in the game. 3rd and 3. And across the field, it's going to be a catch by Norwood. He's got a first down before being taken down at the 35-yard line. So once again, Bravo to Norwood is the connection that is working. 3rd and 11. You got a flag, the throw over the middle. They've got Demaryius Thomas, and they've got a first down. But hold on, is this going to be holding? And will this come back? Will it be 3rd and forever? What will the call be? It is holding, but it is against the defense. Defensive holding, and we are going to decline that and take the big gain. 1st and 10 at the 15 for the Broncos. Hand off to C.J. Anderson. Big hole right up the middle, and he exposes that. Big run for about 9.5 yards down to the 5-yard line. 2nd and inches. Give the ball to Hillman. Hillman is going to get a first down. It'll be 1st and goal at the 2. The passing game got going early, and it's now opened up the running game a little bit. 1st and goal. Anderson checks back in the game, and Anderson dives into the end zone. Touchdown Broncos, and they'll now extend their lead to 17-3. Playing a great first half here on the road. against a team ahead of them in the AFC standings, if you will. They're not in the same division, obviously, but they're all fighting for playoff spots and playoff positioning, something we might not have been talking about 3 weeks ago. DeMarcus Ware comes up with a sack, but now that the Broncos have rattled off three straight wins and looking for four, they can definitely place themselves in that playoff picture. You saw they hold on to an AFC wildcard spot coming into this game. Third and inches now, as you see Bravo got knocked to the ground again, and I have a problem right here. If you run off the left side of your blocker right there, you have an easy first down. Instead, he runs right into the tackle. Watch this. Just cut inside. Think he would have had a first down quite easily. Instead, we're going to have to punt. That's the frustrating part about playing a career mode with one position. You don't get to control everyone else, and you see bonehead moves like that. So we punt it, but you know what? We're getting the ball back on a turnover again. Second turnover by the Titans, and we're going to make them pay. That's Virgil Green catching it for the score. Bravo to Virgil Green, and he's got a touchdown strike. Let's watch it again. They go play action, and they surprise the Titans here, who had a linebacker on Virgil Green. He can't keep up as he goes on into the end zone. And all of a sudden, it's 24-3 Broncos. Oh, no, Aqib Talib's hurt. Hopefully not bad. As this Titans drive goes down the field before halftime, 18-yard pass to Kendall Wright. And it stalls right there. They're going to have another Ryan Succop field goal. The Broncos will be more than happy to trade touchdowns for field goals all day long. C.J. Anderson running up the middle, kind of in our own end here, thinking about maybe running this clock down. We'll see how third and five goes. We will go shotgun here. And Bravo is going to roll to his right, making the defender to choose whether to come up or be in coverage. And he decides briefly to be preoccupied with Bravo there. He throws it over his head for the big gain. Watch the replay again. Freezes him, and oh, there is the cut by Emmanuel Sanders. Recognizing what's going on, he victimizes McCourty for the big gain. Now, all of a sudden, we're looking at a field goal or more. 12 seconds left. That throw is going to be caught. Seconds ticking away, and with 3 seconds left, we will call that final timeout and send Brandon McManus out there to extend the lead. Nice job, though, getting down the field quickly, and they get the 3 points. 27-6 as we start the second half. Brandon Marshall's been injured on this drive. That's not good for our defense. And the Titans knocking on the door here now. 3-yard rush gives them first and goal, and then they knock it in there with the touchdown, the 2-yard run. So it's now 27-13 as we get the football back on offense. C.J. Anderson going to be thrown to the ground right there. Gets a decent gain of about 4 yards. Bravo with a quick 3-step drop, and then he's going to throw, and he hits Virgil Green. Hooked up with him for a touchdown earlier. Now it's going to be a first down at their own 41-yard line. Trying to stretch this out wide to C.J. Anderson. He's got the corner. He's got a first down before being shoved out. Nice gain there, and he's up, what, about 50 yards rushing on the day now. Second and 9, pistol formation, throwing quickly over the middle. Oh, it is so nice to have Emmanuel Sanders back. He opens up a lot of things here for the offense. You take some pressure off Demaryius Thomas, Jordan Norwood, some of these guys who really stepped up while he was gone. Oh, no. We got an injury here, though. C.J. Anderson not getting up after that carry. Oh, boy. He does not look to be very well off right now. He's standing on the sideline trying to shake it off, but whether he comes back or not in this game is very much in doubt. So checking into the game is Ronnie Hillman. He comes in for spells anyway, but now he is your starting back. That's going to be throw over the middle, and it's caught. Bravo over 240 yards passing now. That's going to leave him with 3rd and 3. They're going to try to throw for it. It's caught. It is a first down, or is it? They're going to say 4th and inches. 4th and inches, and so we're just going to take the conservative route here, put 3 more points on the board, and keep that lead at a nice spot. But Marcus Mariota runs for a 49-yard touchdown. My goodness. Couldn't catch him, apparently, and it's now a 10-point game. 30-20. Broncos in the lead. Trying to get a first down on 3rd and 7. They do exactly that. Getting the ball to Ronnie Hillman coming out of the backfield. He catches it, secures it, and gets the Broncos first down. 49-yard line now, 2nd and 9. Zipped over the middle to Demaryius Thomas. Like I said, you open up some room for him with Emmanuel Sanders being back in the field. 3rd and 10 now. Throwing and had his hands on it, but that is going to be incomplete, knocked away as he could not secure the catch. So, oh no, Aqib Talib came back in the game, but he's injured again. He's back out now as we try to stop the Titans, who have some momentum going now. And there's a sack by Von Miller. Big play right there to get the football back. Just under 3 minutes to play. Third and five. Going to give it a chance for Emmanuel Sanders. Why not? That ball is knocked away and incomplete. We will have to punt. Up 10. Another Von Miller sack. Second and 10. And another Von Miller sack. He's taken over in this second half. Mariota, four-yard rush. Nope. They turn the ball over. And now, with just one timeout left, they'll hand off. They got to take their final timeout right there. And they'll get the ball back, but will they have time? Oh, quick score. Andre Johnson gets a touchdown. It's 33-27. Yeah, we did kick a field goal in there, which helps the cause. And, yet, you know, they don't get the onside kick. They don't have any timeouts left, so we're able to finally salt this away. The Broncos win their fourth straight game and now improve to 8-5. The Titans drop to 8-5. 33-27 is the final. Billy Bravo feeling good about the result. Marcus Mariota not quite as much. But wow, okay, coming on the road here and knocking off a team that is ahead of us in the AFC playoff picture. Let's see where we stand here. Both quarterbacks having pretty good days. Mariota throws two picks, and that's kind of the story of the game right there. The two turnovers really was the difference. C.J. Anderson, that was on his way to a pretty good day until he got knocked out of the game. Ronnie Hillman comes in his relief. Booker gets a carry as well in this one. And you see our receiving numbers. Four catches for 96 for Emmanuel Sanders. Touchdowns by Green and Norwood. Good job all around by the Broncos getting the victory. So now we're out of week 14. We're going to look into week 15 in just a minute here. We see what's going on for Billy Bravo and his experience points and his goals. But this is bad news. Aqib Talib out 7 weeks with a dislocated ankle. That is not good at all for our defense. You look at the standings, and we pulled into a first-place tie with the Oakland Raiders. Look at this whole division within one game of each other from top to bottom. 8-5, the Raiders and the Broncos. And you look at the AFC as a whole, we are tied for the best record, a five-way tie for the best record in the AFC. Unbelievable. Would not have thought 4 weeks ago that we'd ever have a shot at that. And we got the New England Patriots coming up next. Tom Brady and company. This should be an awesome game. You don't want to miss it. We'll see you next time.